As well as for sharing your very original and innovative approach towards PE. I'm sure your words are an inspiration to anyone who plans to use private equity for their funding. The next session is a very interesting one. We would like to re-invite our speakers back on the stage again after the next session for the Q&A session. In our next session, we have Mr. Darshan Patel in conversation with Mr. Nipam Shah. To give you a brief introduction, Mr. Darshan Patel, the chairman and MD of Vini Cosmetics, has 30 plus years of experience in successfully launching brands and creating new categories in OTC, wellness and personal care. Some of the household brands that he created as the MD of Paras Pharmaceuticals include Move, Crack, Edgeguard, etc. Vini Cosmetics has raised a funding of $23.52 million. Over to you, Mr. Nipam Shah.
Thank you, Mawsam. Though we are running a bit late, I guess the sessions one after the other are found interesting, and I hope you won't mind if we run a little late for the lunch today. I welcome Darshan Bhai, who has built a very illustrious career for anyone who wants to look at the private equity as a way to go. Darshan Bhai is a serial entrepreneur. He is a founder of Vini Cosmetics. And when he founded this company, in 2010, he decided to take on the multinationals with the personals in the personal care sector. In that space, he came up with a brand, completely a new brand of deodorant spray called Fog. And that name has become a household name in a short period of 6 years' time. Fog has not only, grown so well, but it has toppled the number one brand in this market in the country, which was an HUL brand, AX, and that too in a 6 years of time, which is a very commendable feat for any entrepreneur who puts up such a enterprise from the scratch. So it would be very interesting to hear Darshan Bhai's thoughts on some of his own experiences of building an enterprise through with the help of private equity and how he did so. So Darshan Bhai, you knew from the day one when you started Vini and launched Fog that you are going to take on head-on competition with none else but HUL, which is so resourceful. You had to energize your business plan for that. How exactly you planned that kind of a business?
I love MNCs. And in my 30 years of career, I have always thought of creating something against MNC. In my earlier avatar, when I was in Paras also, I created brands which used to fight with multinational brands only. So 2010, it all started in 2009 when I came out of Paras in 2006 and I was doing nothing except growing some mango trees and chiku trees 100 kilometers away from Ahmedabad. And few of my friends said, "Ki Darshan bhai, you don't doing anything is a crime. Please start something." So around 2009, me and Deepam decided, "Ki let's go back to our old way of thinking, old way of entering into market, and we would like to enter into personal care business." And earlier it was pharma type of business. We said, okay, if we have done some science, marketing science, if we have applied in pharma business, same can be applied in personal care business also. So we started creating architecture of that business. And we always start with, we think, we aim, and we achieve. This, somebody has taught me, Darshan bhai, you should always first think, give lot of time in thinking, then aim the thing, and then you try to achieve that thing. I was entering into very high risk, high reward business. We knew that thing. Personal care business is a very risky business. Very few people attempt to go into that thing. And somebody who is already into that thing, they might know how difficult it is to really do something within that business. Because there is a lot of competition. There are many multinationals who are sitting in India. And there is no place for anybody. But you need to create a place for yourself. So we said, okay, it's a new challenge. Let us go and first set up. You need a team for that thing. You cannot do anything without a team. So you need to have a team. Team on field, on street. So we started with 200 people as team. And we said, okay, now we'll plan 1,000 days. And we said, okay, we'll invest 50 crore rupees into this business. And if we lose this 50 crore, we'll go back to home, we'll sit under the tree of mango, and we'll close down the shop. Otherwise, we'll carry this business. So it all started in 2010. And we said, okay, let us create an architecture of 1,000 days. And we started our journey in 2010.
So interestingly, you started with a plan of 1,000 days, invested and came up with your own risk capital, which you are prepared to lose, of course. But then, alongside, you decided to raise your first private equity before completing 1,000 days, rather in the first year itself. So why so early?
See, there were two reasons. It was not exactly in the first year. It was after 18 months of our operation. So by 18 months, we have created our sales and distribution, which is very essential for a personal care type of business. So we created All India Sales and Distribution. And there was an idea which came to us around 2010 December. That was for the idea of FOCI. We would like to go into this category, which is very crowded. But if we can differentiate a product within this category, there is a place for us. And our research showed us that there is a place for us. So around at that time, we were not ready fully also, because that idea was great. If I could have launched that idea in 2010, I could have been killed also, because multinational could have reacted very fast. They could have stolen my idea, and they could have taken me. I could have been back out of business. So I said, okay, hold this idea. Let us first prepare our sales and distribution. Keep on doing with whatever other products we have, and don't launch this thing. Prepare yourself, then launch. And it was too early in 2010 to launch that product. So we hold that particular idea for one more year. By the time around October 2011, we lost almost 48 crore rupees. So we were sitting with 2 crore rupees, and we wanted to launch this product. So what to do? If you have lost 48 crores, you don't want to put your money back into business. I said, okay, let me put another 10 crores of my money into this thing. We started preparing for the launch. Around that time, people started coming to me, said, Darshan bhai, you have started again, you would like to invest into that thing. And I said, ki, I already lost 50 crore rupees. It's a cash loss. Would you like to invest into me? One Bay Capital from London came, and he said, ki, Darshan bhai, we believe you, and we would like to invest into you. They said, ki, okay. Then I said, ki, okay, I will not take money as you... I will take money as I need, rather than you giving me all the money at a time. And they said, how much you would like to raise? I said, I would like to raise around 50 crore, but it will come in tranches rather than straight away I take 50 crore, because I don't know this idea will take off or not. But in 6 months' time, I'll be able to know that my idea will take off, and today is my valuation. See, everybody is talking about Gujarati. They're very reluctant in their valuation. I was also very reluctant. If I am taking you, this is my valuation. Take it or forget it. And they took that risk, and they invested into me. So it was only because of I lost 48, 50 crore rupees of mine.
Very interesting. So it's very interesting to know that even after piling losses in the initial period to the extent of 48 crores out of 50 that you brought in, investors valued this company to your satisfaction. And you also balanced the dilution by taking money in tranches, which probably you did not take the full.
Sure. I took around 28 crore rupees and I diluted 14% of my stake at that point.
And what was that unique thing? We don't have the bank people over here, Bay people over here to ask that question, otherwise you would have asked them. But they must have seen something very unique in Vinnie Cosmetics or either in Darshan Patel.
I think it was more into Darshan Patel rather than Vinnie Cosmetics because they knew me because when I came out of my family business in 2006, at that point of time they contacted me and they told me, Darshan bhai, if you are starting anything new, we would like to invest into you. So it was that early in 2006 and they kept on meeting me. But when I started, they said, okay, Darshan bhai, take our capital, we would like to partner with you. I said, no, I would like to put my money into this business first because my skin has to be there in this business. You can give me capital, but I don't want to take this thing. This is very high risk, high reward business, but this is very, very risky business. It might not take off, and I don't want to take responsibility from day one that I'll be successful or not.
One more very interesting thing, Darshan bhai, when someone looks at Vinnie Cosmetics balance sheet for, you know, starting from 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, you have hardly used any debt. You know, it was 100% kind of an equity-driven business. Whenever you use debt, it was probably some lines of credit for working capital and not beyond that. So why you never considered debt and gave priority to equity over the debt?
See, my type of business, no bank will finance me. No bank will finance me because there is not at all a single tangible asset in my company. My company is very light asset based company, right? My company even doesn't have one single car also. So there is not a single car in my company. Only is brand and business. There is nothing there. Even I don't have factory also. So banks don't finance brands. They finance tangible assets. And there was no tangible asset with me. And later on, yes, there was debt available to me, but I always thought ki serving a debt beyond a point is not good in our type of business because debt is also a responsibility and bank take everything that they have all the first charge rather than anything else, and that first charge they will ask me to write down my home also, which I don't want to do. I have a different approach for business.
Very interestingly, I think many of us as an entrepreneur, when we think of a product, we first think of the land, and then the factory, and then the plant and equipments, and then the product. And last comes the money for marketing. You did exactly reverse. You thought of a product, you assigned all your capital to the marketing, and kept the business asset light. Do you think that is possible for any business or it is very typical of this business only?
It depends, but in our type of business, there are a lot of spare capacity available for producing personal care product. There are third party manufacturing which are available. But now, see, now we have one third party manufacturer who does only our work. He doesn't do anything else, so now there are third-party manufacturers who have invested in us, we would like to do business only with you, and they are producing around 4.5 million cans of fog every day. When we started, we had four contract manufacturers. Now we have only one.
Darshan bhai, you are a person of very independent mind, thought, and you always do, you know, what your heart asks you to do. Now, with these kind of background, now you have two equity investors with you, private equity investors. Do you face any challenge in those relationships?
Not exactly, but I'll tell you why I went for second round also. It is very important because I see ki when a new business starts, it starts with crawling, then it starts walking, and then it starts turning also. And you need capital at each and every stage. So I know exactly my first year turnover was 20 crore. At 50 crore we raised first capital, first round of capital. It was my turnover was 50 crore. From that we grew to 168 crore. At 168 crore we said ki okay, now we would like to go beyond India also. We would like to spread in India also. And we were growing 100%, 150%, 200%. We said ki okay, and we were anticipating competition also to come. And because if you don't have money, multinational can spend any amount of money and they can take you out of the market also. They can discount their brand, they can increase their share of voice in advertising. So we said ki okay, let us go for second round. And at that time we chose a partner which was Sequoia. It was a good partner to have. And when I met Abhay for the first time, he said ki Darshan bhai, would like to invest in you. I said I am very costly, Abhay, you will not be able to invest in me because my valuations are very costly. He said ki Darshan bhai, paisa to banate nahi ho, kitna costly hoga. Maine bola paisa nahi banata hu to bhi costly hoga. It's a costly proposition. And he said ki okay, what, see, 1 year back my valuation was 200 crore and I asked him 800 crore valuation and he was jabbed. He said ki how it is possible. I said ki okay, take it or forget it. And he took it, and that 168 crore took us to 350 crore and 350 crore to 500 crore, and this year we'll be closing 725 crore. So that capital has helped us to ramp up our business, and it was a wise call to take that second round also, because now we are into 43 countries also.
So I think the best part was that you had the calculations, you had your plans, private equity came in and the plans were successful. By this time, I don't think now you can say that Vini Cosmetic is not generating cash. It is a cash generating company. And you already have announced, and the matter is already publicly announced, that you are looking to grow through now acquisitions. For that also, do you think you would further like to dilute and take equity for the purpose of inorganic growth?
Yes. Because if I have to grow beyond a point, because we are already 725, and if we don't grow inorganically, we'll grow to say 850 or 900 crore next year. That is a simple way to keep on doing that business. But beyond a point, now Vishal bhai was here and he said ki going public is a right thing to do, and I would like to do a IPO somewhere around 2019-20. And before going there, I would like to be seen as more than 1500 crore turnover company, and I don't mind raising another round of capital to grow inorganically.
There is a tremendous amount of clarity of thought, and I guess if this kind of clarity can one work with, I think anything is possible. So before we conclude, Darshan bhai, I just would like to you know, request you to give any message, because we have entrepreneurs from various different lines of activity. Everybody may have very different equation of their own business and balance of risk and the protection of their equity. So what would be your message?
See, I would like to say, see, you have given a topic, private equity is a salt in a business. I say it is not a salt, it's a catalyst in a business. They come with us in a reaction of doing business, and they would like to come out of a business after 5-7 years So they play role of catalyst, and whoever wants to grow beyond a point. See, I always believe business is about creating value. Business is not emotion. Business is not charity. If you want to do charity, there are many ways to do that thing. Business is about creating money for yourself, money for your family. Because if you have worked so hard these 30, 40 years, and if you don't create value for your money, then okay, fine, you could have earned year on year, you could have paid income tax year on year, but you have not created value for yourself. And I would like to tell you, business is about creating value for a business. And there are many buyers of business, sellers of business, merger and acquisition will happen, you can grow yourself also. But don't limit yourself thinking taking capital from outside is going to hamper my this thing. It is going to make your dream true also. If you can dream big, and I would like to request you, dream big, because somebody has taught me, Darshan bhai, business is about making money, creating value for yourself and for your peer circle.
Thank you very much, Darshan bhai.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Darshan Patel and Mr. Nipam Shah, for such a lively and interesting session.